New at 5, insulin that you inhale instead of inject. Could it be a game changer for diabetics? Health editor Dr. Maria Simbra looks into the benefits and drawbacks of this pain-free option.
For some people with diabetes, injecting insulin is the only way to keep their blood sugars under control. What if there was another way?
When you inhale something, it gets in the body very quickly and works very quickly and then goes away quickly.
Inhaled insulin is a quicker, easier way to get the medicine into your body. People get less of a spike in blood sugar after eating.
Inhaled insulin came about 6 years ago and has undergone some refinement. The initial version was linked to a decrease in lung function at 6 months and had to be taken off the market. Even with the current version, doctors still have to carefully watch how well the lungs work.
Even now, any inhaled insulin, you still have to make sure they don't have COPD or any other lung problem, and you still have to measure lung function before and during. So that's a deterrent a little bit to doctors.
The device looks like an inhaler. You insert capsules of insulin in different doses depending on your needs based on blood sugar readings.
There are some preparations they have to do. You have to put a capsule in the bottle. You have to measure it right. And not that you don't have to measure insulin, but it's a little more involved. The advantage, I guess, is people don't like to take shots.
It tends to be more popular with his younger, more tech-savvy patients, but even so, it isn't for most of them.
We live in Pittsburgh, and there's a lot of COPD, both from smoking as well as, you know, the pollutants.
And it's about double the cost of injectable insulin.
Very few insurances are paying for it now because it's very expensive.
There are a few case reports of cancer.
It's irritating. And if you remember, insulin is a growth hormone. So when you put insulin in the lung, there's always that fear that you get growth of lung tissue as well.
And it may not work well in the long run.
It's in a foreign place, so the body attacks it. So there was some worry about anti-insulin antibodies forming from this. So yes, it could become less effective with time.
I'm Dr. Maria Simbra, KDKA-TV News.